The Incredible Hulk will not be presented this evening.
These days, almost every kid likes to play Star Wars, imagining himself perhaps as Luke Skywalker, preparing to soar into battle against the powers of the Empire. But few backyard barnstormers of the Star Wars set can play the game in quite the style of 7-year-old Doug Bundy. Doug has his own half-ton mock-up of an X-Wing fighter, the little spacecraft the Rebels used against Darth Vader's Death Star in Star Wars. It's 12 feet long, has an 8-foot pivoting wingspan, and to play in it, he only has to go as far as his own backyard. Doug's X-Wing was a very special Christmas surprise from his dad, who spent about 150 hours over a 4-month period building it in secret. Now, Doug Bundy Sr. is a pretty imaginative craftsman. He built most of his own house himself, incorporating such unusual items as the floor from the old Bonnie Slope school gymnasium and a wood stove that he fashioned from a length of 1/4-inch pipe. The X-Wing, though, presented some special challenges in creative scrounging, but Doug Sr. was equal to the task. In moments of wild inspiration, he even turned golf club tubes into laser cannons and nylon stocking containers into center portions for the jet engines. Doug's dad admits that building the X-Wing revived some of his own childhood pleasures and frustrations. As a boy, he often whiled away the hours playing in a box airplane with a board for wings sticking through it. And once, when another kid bragged about building a helicopter that actually flew, Doug Sr. spent days trying to whittle a rotor blade out of a 4x6. So you can imagine his satisfaction in giving his own child the ultimate Star Wars toy.
Well, young Doug is certainly no novice when it comes to Star Wars lore. In fact, his bedroom is a virtual museum of Star Wars paraphernalia. He's got everything from the miniature figures of the Star Wars characters to models of the spaceships in the film. There's even a Star Wars mural above his bed.
While Doug Bundy Sr. believes Doug Jr.'s Star Wars mania is a generally healthy preoccupation, he confesses that he hoped the boy would, to use his phrase, burn out a little after getting the big X-Wing. Don't count on it, though.
Do you think you're ever going to get tired of Star Wars?
Yeah, probably.
How long do you think that's going to take?
50 years.
We'll be right back. This was good acting, I thought, on both of our parts.
This is just our blade rip off of the cave. Then there's supposed to be there's a flight scene there, and how we.
All right, so like,
that's terrible.
We've got you're on the left there. I think that's just the way that the
just the action.
Yeah, you're moving so fast, and then that's Mike Faulkner.
Mike Faulkner,
yeah. As Darth Vader. Let's see.
And don't forget, I spent a lot of time. I remember this with the red construction paper.
Oh,
cutting out this paper because this was in our basement of our house on Lovejoy.
Right there, you lose your hand.
Yeah.
What was that like? I mean, how did you prepare for that scene?
I was watching a lot of Vietnam flicks. The costuming, by the way, let's talk about the costuming here.
Yeah.
This is probably the best place to get into the fact that that was just you showing them straight up from school.
Yeah.
You wore that outfit. Well,
that's pretty much my outfit. Well, you can't tell that I'm wearing my shin guards, too. That was the other part of my outfit.
Oh, that's right.
And that's Chris.
That's Chris Reed
behind us as Chewbacca, dressed in your mom's fur coat.
On backwards.
On backwards, and she made a mask.
Yeah.
Okay.
There was three pieces of fur fabric and a button nose.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
So, Ico, and that's a legit Han blaster, by the way. There. Mm-hmm. That was an official Star Wars blaster. So, let's see. Mm-hmm. I attack. Now, see, a lot of people don't know, this is actually you.
Mm-hmm.
In the Stormtrooper helmet.
Yeah.
A lot of people thought there was another kid on the production, but that was your...
It's just the range.
You had a lot of range. Here's where you come in. Now, just to back up, I don't mean to break this all down too much, but the first scene...
And you get shot.
I get shot. Let's just look at that one more time. That is some real method. For me, you were talking about how you prepared for your role.
Mm-hmm.
I was really focused on just really being in the emotion of it.
Mm-hmm.
You can see me kind of fight. I'm fighting through. I'm hit.
Yeah.
And I know that we got to get out of here, and I wave him on to get us out. So
Now back up once again. All right. I see that
the set designs are
set designs. Unbelievable. Okay, and then from here, after that initial battle with Darth Vader,
yeah.
And there was another spaceship scene.
Okay. Now, what was the breakdown? I remember filming those scenes. Was this a post-production issue? Was there... I'm trying to remember why... I remember talking to your mom about it.
Yeah.
I got a lot of excuses.
This is basically the blatant ripoff of The Empire Strikes Back, as if the movie The Empire Strikes Again wasn't enough.
This is really where all heck breaks loose.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got karate going. I mean, that is...
But there's... The interesting thing is, I don't remember how we got from one scene to the next. Was that supposed to be the training?
I think there was another, kind of like in the Star Wars movies where they've got multiple plots going on at the same time.
Yeah.
Very similar. We were trying to get that aesthetic.
The other thing that's hard about this, too, is the framing of the shot is absolutely dreadful.
It really is. How your mom, she basically cuts her head off in this scene, I don't know how that happens. Oh, this time Chewie brings...
comes to help.
He brings the heat this time.
Yeah.
He's got a board. Hang on, that's my agent. I'm going to grab that.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Stormtrooper shoots at nothing, then shoots at Han and Chewie. He gets a vicious karate kick.
A lot of people don't know this, though, but Han kicked first.
Han kicked first.
Definitely kicked first.
Yeah.
And don't believe anyone who's watching this in some reproduction of this where all of a sudden there's a... blaster bolt from the Stormtrooper, and then I kick the 2x4 out of his hand.
Yeah,
I always kicked first,
and I go down.
Now, was there a way? Did we ever conceptualize this? I'm trying to remember the planning stages where there was like a almost like a sitcom part here, and it's like down in the cave you will go.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
See, that would killed.
Yeah.
Well, it's probably just as well there wasn't sound, because there was usually. I mean, your dad is in the background swearing up a storm about something.
Yeah.
You know, yelling at the television. And, you know, we might have talked about this already, but again, no sound track at all.
Yeah. All the tradition.
Right.
Of the silent picks.
So it was, I think definitely homage. And I think technologically.
This is where you would have had the jangly, like, piano music.
Right. So going forward, you know, we may have the capacity now to take this to another level. I mean, mm-hmm. the technology has changed quite a bit since we filmed this.
Yeah.
One of the problems that I've noticed, and we've never really talked about this that I know of, but I signed all the rights away to this to your mom.
Yeah.
And yeah, so, I mean, if we're going to engage in a project that takes some of this footage and maybe, like, modernizes it or whatever, like, we'll probably have to get a lawyer.
Yeah.
And get those contracts opened back up and try to figure out how to proceed.
I like to think that our video has been the inspiration on millions of other kids, the same way the original Star Wars was an inspiration on us. So, if, you know, it's the yin and yang of it. You take the good, you take the bad.
Yeah.
You take them both, and there you have.
Facts of life.
Yeah, so well, that's the way it is. Facts of life of the show business.
We can get some Indiegogo money or some Kickstarter money, mm-hmm. and let's see if we can get this thing retooled.
Yeah, let's crowdsource this.
I mean, because it's really, like, if you think about it now, this new movie coming out, I mean, people are stoked. People want it. Quality content is never going out of style. People are going to want this. They're going to want it modernized. They're going to want it in mobile.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. We should have more to make this come to the full potential of what we had envisioned it being.
It's a dream, and I hope it's gonna I hope it's gonna happen.
Yeah, so we need your help. Han, drop me off in Dagobah.
You got it.
Thank you.
I'm going to go to the hospital.